So, you guys remember these two big passes like this, right? Your two beats. What these will turn into is when he throws a jab, you can bridge, or you can hammer fist, or you can even just check it like that. A couple of ways to check. I can go one, two, do it with a hammer, it's up to you, right? Let's say we just check like that. Doesn't have to be too deep. I can get this, it's not a problem. But if I do this one, I'm leaving this on this side. This front hand stays on the front side, as in over here, not over here. Because then I'd have to bring it all the way back. Because when I go one, next one comes, I've got one, two, right? So I can do this type of entry, but it can also turn into one, one, two, nice and deep. So the elbow clears like this, hammer fist or elbow, grab him, elbow again. Even when we clamp this, it's a lateral a lot of the time. We like to leave our hands free because we're gonna go for his weapon. We might body clinch, we might even do whatever the fuck. But we don't like to do all these ones. You know, in the grappling arts, like BJJ, we talk about two on one a lot. We kind of do the opposite to that. We want to access our weapon, access their weapon, have hands free. It's a fucking positive thing. Okay, when you're talking about, you know, everything is a possibility, you know what I mean? Like a weapon or an elbow or a punch or a knee or a kick. In a grappling arts, a lot of the time it's just grappling versus grappling. Does that make sense? So that's why the tactic is a little bit different. There. Considerations are different. Okay. So for this series, you can go one, one, two. And this one comes out wide. So again, if I want a hammer fist from there, then lead rear. That's something you can do. Or I can windscreen wiper it and go one, there, windscreen wiper like that. So it really puts him out. And the hammer fist is really, I want to put him out that way. So then, you see? See what happened there is I've switched stance, but I haven't. Can you see that? I was here, and because I made him face that way, just a concept I want to introduce, this, his reaction to this is likely to put him that way. So I follow up like that, meaning that now I've switched to southpaw, but I haven't, you know what I mean? I haven't done these ones. It's unnecessary. This step here can be deep, so it goes to this side, and now I've got a takedown. So as soon as I go forward and then back, I've got that sweep. So I check, one, one, two. Now, the first hand out of that two beat has to be the one that gets rid of it. It has to deal with the punch. But my first hand here on this side, it's just checking it, because that's a jab is usually a setup for something else, right? So when the cross comes, the first hand has to fuck that off. Please don't think that it's the second hand, like one, two, it's not. It's not at all. It's the first hand that gets rid of that, and the second hand goes blap. You see, so I wanted to slow that down for you because I was concerned that maybe you think that this has to happen. It's not at all, okay? Your hands, one and two, are most important. These passes are most important. That's your basic, right? So I go one, fuck off. That's my attitude. This comes up underneath. That's all that's happening there, okay? So you go one, two. That's how that happens. Because most of you will be thinking, I don't have the time or the dexterity or whatever to make this happen. You do. You just have to make the first response, one, this one, work. Does that make sense? Don't let it tag you, right? It's got to be off your fuck, and then this one can come up. Cool? You can draw a hammer fist, but same thing. Same progression.